Welcome along, everybody. This is a video I've thought about for a little while. At least the idea, maybe not the execution so much. And it might not be for everybody. But as some of you may know from some of my videos, I've mentioned it once or twice. I am something called a subsea planning engineer. And I thought it would be quite interesting to try and find a way to teach you some of the basic but fundamental principles of planning. Not just subsea planning engineering, but planning engineering in general. And I thought it would be easier if I started with something that almost everyone can relate to or has done at some point in their life. So we're going to take making a cup of tea as our example piece. Now, I did actually start this video as a role play. I had shot the first portion of it with a green screen in like an office, and I decided that the character that I ended up becoming was a bit too pretentious and a bit too condescending. Not to say that all bosses and people of authoritative figures are like that, but I decided to take a bit of inspiration from one of my favorite ASM artists. I don't know if they'll see this, but DDOD, and keep it really quite organic. So, full disclosure, I have to make two very sincere apologies before we start. I am dyslexic, so I spell like a 10-year-old. Actually, that's probably an insult to 10-year-olds across the world. More like a 5-year-old. And I write like a 3-year-old. So ignore my writing. Thankfully, in my work, I get to hide my shortcomings behind the monitor of a computer. But I think it might be kind of fun just to apply the principles of planning. Some of the things that we're going to change, you might already be doing without thinking about it. But anyway, I'm going to start on this left-hand side with activities. I hope the text is going to come through clean enough. And if my pen dies, I have provision to spare. Okay. Now, activities is simply the steps we go through to create a cup of tea. Okay? In this middle portion, we're going to have the actual, we can call it a program or a schedule. Call it a program. And on this right-hand side, we're going to list the principles of planning that we're going to try and apply to this. I could call it concepts, but we'll call it principles. Okay. So, from here, I'm going to draw a little separation line. Down our page. So, in planning, you can break down activities into sub-activities, obviously. So, when we go to make a cup of tea, let's assume we're already in the kitchen. What's some of the things that we're most likely to do? We would probably get the cup. Get cup. Okay. Then we might get the spoon. might get the tea back. And we might add sugar and milk and the water. You could actually break down adding the water and getting sugar and milk as separate activities, but not everyone takes sugar and milk in their tea. I think maybe I'm the only person that actually does because I have a very sweet tooth. Okay, so we have our activities. Now we're going to turn these into durations. So for that, we need a duration line. Now, planning is usually done with what's called a Gantt chart. So you have your activities and your durations are represented in what's called a Gantt chart. Nearly nobody outside of planning or project management has seen a Gantt chart. So they look very similar, actually, but we're going to draw a graph. A Gantt chart, usually your activity, your duration line goes along the top. But because people have seen a graph, we're going to draw an axis. Like this, just beneath there. Okay. And along here, we're going to draw our timeline. So obviously the line is zero. And we're going to go in 10-second increments. Increments, rather. 10. 20. 2 minutes would probably be long enough. Maybe a bit more, maybe. Go to 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Okay, so we have our activities. Now we need to put in durations for how long these things take. So, get cup. You walk into the kitchen, you open the cupboard, take a cup. Let's say it takes 20 seconds. To do. And obviously, normally you would do this, you wouldn't do it with a piece of paper, you would do it with a piece of software that measures the 20 for you. You put in the duration and it moves the bar to 20. So maybe they won't line up perfectly, but the principle is the same. So move that to the 20, and we'll take it as thick as the next activity. So this is our get cup duration. That's 20 seconds. Okay. After we've got the cup, we'll get the spoon. Maybe because we're already in the kitchen, it only takes 10 seconds. So we go from 20 to 30. Appreciate the 10 second box is not as a bit bigger than half the 20 seconds, but the size of the bar is not really as important as what the duration is. Okay, so we're 30 seconds into our schedule. And now we're going to boil the kettle. Maybe boiling the kettle takes, a minute and 10, so 70 seconds. So that's like 100, right? See my math there? Incredible. Okay. Okay. So we've got our 70 seconds, okay? So now the kettle's boiled and we get our tea back. Sorry, get tea. Maybe that takes 20 seconds. Let's say 10 seconds, probably more realistic. Well, I think about it, you might reach up, pull the thing down. Yeah, 20 seconds is probably. So we draw out to the 120 line. And again, I appreciate this 20-second box. There's nothing like that 20-second box. Again, I apologize. I don't think I can blame that on dyslexia, but again, it's the duration that's important, not so much the size of the box. Of course, the size of the box should be perfectly relevant to the duration, but never mind. Okay, so we've got our tea, we've got our cup, got our spoon, waited for the kettle to boil, got our tea, then we add our sugar and water. That probably takes 10 seconds. Okay, 10 seconds. 120 to 130. So, when we want to make a cup of tea, we now know that it takes us this amount of time. So we'll do a quick sum. And maths is a weakest part of my overall game in life. Even worse than my writing, probably. So, 20 seconds, I'll just do it up here. 20, 10, 70, 230 seconds per cup of tea. Now we can multiply that by maybe you have 6 cups of tea a day. You could probably apply a similar schedule for a cup of coffee, probably with subtle nuances, but so let's times this by 6. Some people have considerably more. I know some people have 10, 11, 12 cups in a day, but we'll keep things kind of simple. Okay, so that's 780 seconds. 780 seconds a day we're spending making tea, which just divide that by 60 to get it in minutes. Is exactly 13. So 13 minutes a day we spend just making tea, not drinking tea. So a quarter of an hour. Now if we times this by 365, that should be a times, not a divide. That's 4,000 minutes, 745. That didn't make any sense. 4745. And again, you can divide that by 60 if you want to get it in hours. And you can go on and on with this. But that's quite a lot of time to be spending just making tea. So if we want to try and reduce that just a little bit, here's what we do. We introduce planning principles, which is kind of the whole purpose of this video. So what are some of the planning principles we can apply? So the first thing we can do, and I can't spell this, is apply compression. Compression. So what does compression look like? Compression is when you look at each activity in isolation and think, how can we do this activity quicker? Now we can't really get the cup any quicker, get the spoon any quicker, without introducing risk, and very rarely do you want to introduce risk to your schedule. Sometimes it's inevitable, but this kind of risk is usually regarding or in regards to your health, so we definitely don't want to kind of have you running into the kitchen and like moving sporadically. So these activities probably can't be condensed any further than they are. The boil kettle, we could definitely do something about. Now, this is the assumption. I don't actually know how long it takes to boil a kettle, but let's say it's 70 seconds for a plastic kettle. If we were to replace this with a metal kettle or a stainless steel kettle, you could probably take 20 seconds of that. So we could take off this shaded portion of your schedule, then whenever you go to make a cup of tea, you always save this 20 seconds. So then these activities start here. They're starting earlier. And whenever you, this is called moving to the left. When I say the left, that's closer to your starting point. So these activities have moved to the left, which means they're starting earlier. And of course, if you start something earlier, you finish earlier. So your schedule has now went from 130 seconds down to 110. And again, if you were to feed that into these numbers, you are saving an awful lot of time. Okay, so that's compression. Next thing, the next principle I'd like to introduce are relationships. Okay, relationships work a little bit like what activity depends on the other thing happening before it can begin. So, making a cup of tea is the perfect example. If we were to look at this overall schedule, can we get the spoon before we've got the cup? Yes, there, it doesn't matter which order you do these in. It doesn't matter. They can't be done together because you only have one person. This is kind of getting to the next level of planning, but then you could apply two resources. Two people could then make a cup of tea, so you can reduce the duration of these things. That's kind of relating into compression, but we won't go into resources. That's probably not even lesson two. That would be like level lesson three or four. But so for right now, these things, it doesn't matter which order you do them in, but one has to happen after the other. However, do you have to wait to get your spoon and get your cup before you boil your kettle? No, you don't. You could boil the kettle and then get your cup and your spoon, which means your whole schedule moves to the left and you save these 30 seconds. And I'll explain, I'll redraw this schedule applying relationships, because I appreciate that explanation wasn't very clear. But this time we're going to reorganize the order. And this isn't a principle, but this is called OOE. And what OOE is, actually it's just OE, order of execution. And that's just the order in which you do the activities. So if we boil the kettle first, we can be getting the cup and getting the spoon while the kettle is boiling. We could also get the tea and put it in the tea bag. So right away, we'd be saving 50 seconds, because those 50 seconds can be done during the kettle boiling time. That's, I'll show you what I mean. So now we're going to boil the kettle first. And of course, if you did this in software, it reorganizes the order for you. You don't always have to write out a new schedule. Boil kettle. And while the kettle is boiling, we'll get cup, get spoon. Okay, we just had a bit of a disaster. The camera fell off its oh-so-stable tripod, because it's fixed right down, so if the screen has changed, I sincerely apologize. I hope it won't disrupt things too much, but okay, so we're in the middle of getting our spoon. Okay, and then we can also get our tea. And then you can add sugar in the milk if you take it, but I think that activity should really come after the kettle is boiled. So it still kind of follows on, but you'll see what I mean. Add water. Okay. the same thing again. We draw our line. This will be a bit harder to do, actually, but it's okay. Damn. I hope you can see these numbers in the actual video. I'm a little bit worried that you won't be able to, but at the very least, as I said, you can just close your eyes and listen to my voice. And if the video isn't relaxing enough to send you to sleep, the boredom of being taught planning engineering will probably be the only catalyst you'll need. I know some of you thought this. For anyone that follows me on Twitter, you might have seen the picture. Thought I was going to be doing a Draw Your Life video, which I haven't actually seen a Draw Your Life video, so I'll have to have a look at one, and maybe that's something else we can do if anybody wants to see this writing ever again. Okay, so I'm deciding whether or not we apply the compression to buying a new kind of kettle. The 70 seconds was with a plastic kettle, and we took it down. I think we'll keep it a budget schedule, so we didn't buy anything else, but that's an option of compression. Buying better materials, buying more efficient machinery, that kind of stuff. But we'll keep it at 70 seconds, just for continuity's sake. I don't want to introduce too much at once, if I haven't already done that. So that's our 70 second duration. However, normally we would start here. We're going to start here, because you can introduce here what's called a lag. Actually, this is more like level 2, 3, but a lag means that these activities start together, but because we only have one person, they all might take a little while to get something started. So in the case of boiling a kettle, we're going to have a 10-second lag. So we're going to wait 10 seconds before we start the get cup. Okay, so we get cup. Get cup was 20 seconds, so we start at 20, and we go to 40. 20 seconds. Then our spoon was 10 seconds, so that's 40 to 50. I just realized that that's actually 10 seconds. That would take you to 30 seconds, not 40. Nearly didn't spot that. Again, a computer usually does this for you. Okay, our get spoon activity starts here at 30 seconds for 10 seconds. Ignore that. 10 seconds. Okay, our get tea activity was 10 seconds. So we go from 40 to 50 for get tea. This is all happening while the kettle is boiling, which, as I said, is compressing your schedule because of relationships. Okay, now the add water and sugar can't happen until the boil activity is finished, so it's still happening down here, and it was 10 seconds. So it takes you from your 70 to your 80. And on a schedule, that's represented by a little line that just comes down there. And that leads on to that. Okay? And this was 10 seconds. So what have we gained by applying relationships to our schedule? We've now went, instead of having the 20, the 10, the 70, the 20, and the 10, we only have the 70 and the 10. Which means the grand total, or the grand duration, I should say, for making our cup of tea is now down to 80 seconds from 130. So again, if we want to do the rest of the math, we times that by our 6 cups, which is 480. divided by 60 to get, we times it by 6 to get our seconds, divided by 60 to get our minutes, which is 8. So we're now down to 8 minutes a day of making tea instead of the 13 we had up here. Again, if you want to times this by 365, we're now down to 2,920. So let's subtract that. Which means we save 1,825. minutes divided by 60 is 30 hours. So we just saved you, most people who work full-time work like a 37 and a half hour a week. We just saved you almost one full working week just in making tea alone. And we didn't even include buying a better kettle to reduce your boiling time. You could actually even go further than that. You could replace your kettle with one of those boiling hot water taps, which would take your duration down to like 10 seconds, the time it takes to fill a cup. So, of course, you still have some of the duration of getting your spoon or your cup, but it's going to take you to about here, because you still need this time to do those, so it would take you to about here. However, I hope that if you're still watching the video by some miracle, just I'll quickly kind of review what's on the screen if you're like, oh my god, this is a lot of words. OOE is our order of operations. That's just the order in which we have our activities happening. We changed our OOE here. We changed our OOE here to boil the kettle first. So these activities happen while the kettle is boiling. Compression is when you try and reduce the duration of activities. For example, buying a better kettle reduces it from 70 seconds down to 50. Relationships, kind of similar to order of operations, but they're a bit more complicated than that. It's not so much the order, it's what you could add on a subsection to relationships called dependencies. What has to happen before something else can happen? Can they start together? Can they start while that's happening? That kind of stuff. But that's for lesson two, if anyone's crazy enough to want a lesson two. Yeah, so order of operations, our activities, our overall schedule. This is your Gantt chart, as I mentioned. This is your planning principles. And we've saved 30 hours a year making tea just by readjusting the order in which we do things. Now, some of you might watch this and say, well, I do this anyway. That's okay. It just means you've applied a logical principle to the order in which you do things. But the principle still applies in planning anywhere else, whether you're planning a wedding or planning a major overhaul subsea control system. That's what I do. It's the same thing. You just need to know the order of things, how long they take, what they need to make them happen. And as I said, in later lessons, I'll introduce something called schedule risk analysis, earned value, all these crazy things. But so yeah, you can now basically tell people that you're a trainee planning engineer. And you can talk about compression, relationships, order of operations, all these not very cool things. Okay, I think that probably draws it to about a close. I hope this was enjoyable for at least one person. I hope the disruption of the camera moving wasn't too traumatic and didn't ruin it too much. I hope you can read the writing, but... Sleep well. See you soon, folks.